There you go, guys. I did it in like one take. That is I Want to Hold Your Hand, live in the Ed Sullivan, their debut on February 9th, 1964. Debut on the Ed Sullivan Show, the first performance. And here's the DVD. Just got done watching it to refresh my memory. Check it out. Again, I talked about before. There's the rehearsal. That's a rehearsal photo. Notice the Ludwig Stockhead on Ringo's new 20-inch bass drum Ludwig Black Oyster Pearl kit. I believe was purchased at Manny's Music. Again, when Ringo came to America with the Beatles, he only brought his snare drum from the first Ludwig kit and his cymbals and his drop T logo head number 2. And he purchased a the second Black Oyster Pearl Ludwig kit. And again, he was provided a white Marine Pearl Ludwig kit, which can be seen in some photos during the rehearsals, along with Neil Aspinall filling in for George Harrison on the rehearsals, because George Harrison was out sick. And you see this white Ludwig Marine Pearl kit, but Ringo just doesn't look right with it. And it was just meant to be for them to swap the kit out, give him the new Ludwig kit, Black Oyster Pearl wrap, that is, which it stood out, you know, obviously it stood out. It was more of the Ringo color kit. Here you go. There's some cool pictures. Beatles Anniversary Collector's Edition. I got this magazine a long time ago. Talk about this magazine, stress it enough. Here he goes, photos. Ed Sullivan appearance right up here. It might have been playing I Want to Hold Your Hand, or I Saw Her Standing There There. I Saw Her Standing There in that photo. Or I Want to Hold Your Hand. I can tell by the stage setup. Again, there's three performances in February 1964. And then they did a performance in September, on September 12th, 1965, right after the release of Help. But we'll get to that later. There's a photo down there during the rehearsal. Paul McCartney showing Ed Sullivan how to shred on the Hofner violin bass. There's a really cool part in I Want to Hold Your Hand. Now, this is old school technology. I thought was really cool from watching the footage. There's a part where there's a camera like somewhere above the studio, the stage, and it kind of zooms in, it kind of moves in on Ringo, and you can tell there's microphones on the camera and the drums get kind of loud, and I thought that was so cool. And it kind of zooms right like a bird's eye view, almost like I'm here, the camera would be like right here. Zooms in real close to Ringo. You can really see his kit well. And you can hear the drums get kind of loud. That's because the camera's kind of zooming in. I thought that was pretty cool. So there's little things that I just noticed that I think's pretty cool. There goes a Hal Leonard drum collection book to Ringo Starr's drum compositions to the Beatles studio tracks for a bunch of hits. I Want to Hold Your Hand. I Want to Hold Your Hand. Although some of the bootleg stuff, they put I Want to Hold Your Hand. 76. There you go. Did this in like one take. I wanted to kind of play it live. And again, I talked about the fill. Here's the fill down here. They don't have the measures numbered, unfortunately. But here's the fill. Right there, my index finger is on this measure right here. And if you see Ringo do the fill, he's leading with his left hand, which I've talked about before. It's just 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. 1 and. So it's 1 and 2 and. got to get the right hand swing like Ringo. Never seen anyone do that, but I guess that was his thing. That was his way of keeping time. Maybe it was a nerve thing. But I do it just to, you know, make the videos fun and keep it in the Richard Starkey vibe here. Again, there's times where I use my 18-inch Zildjian LV80 low-volume 18-inch crash ride with a ProMark Sizzler. The Sizzler, you can see there's the rivets on the... Can't tell if it's an 18-inch or a 20. It almost looks like a 20-inch cymbal he has over here. It looks kind of big in the footage and the pictures. But you can see the rivets in it. And I think I believe he did use Zildjian's. There's Beatles book here. Yeah. Another rehearsal photo. I think that's the same photo I showed. Here. But I like the Sizzlers I use for my these Beatle videos in particular, because you can hear, or I try to use it to mimic all the screaming girls and all the screaming people out there. It sounds pretty cool. More pictures here shown before. There you go, I Want to Hold Your Hand. Okay, there's a Capitol Records single. Label of the US 7-inch single I Want to Hold Your Hand, released by Capitol Records. Yeah, this is a great photo. Getting off the airplane February 7th, 1964. We talked about Neil Aspinall, the fill-in for George Harrison during the rehearsals. We talked about the stage setup was slightly changed also. It was originally like a black stage, and it just said the Beatles real big and white. That was changed to the arrows and then the stripes, which I thought looked better. And then, let's see here. We'll talk more about the guitars when we start doing the guitar stuff here. Again, 3 million views. Wow. And then, what other photos we got here? Got some stuff here. Quaker's Ringo Starr's Ludwig Black Oyster Pearl 20-inch kit. That's kit number 2 used on the Ed Sullivan. This is the Beatles gear book again. Pretty beat up there. You can also see in some photos too during 64 where you see the snare drum head heavily worn and beaten in. And that's because the snare was from the first kit that he had, that he left back in London, and he only brought the snare and the cymbals over, like I said. So that's why you see the tom heads very white and clean, because it was brand new. I always wondered about that stock logo Ludwig had. I couldn't figure that out. So maybe that's a new kit. So I was right. That's apparently what it was. And down here, again, here's the surviving rack tom and snare drum from his first Ludwig 20-inch bass drum kit. So that must be the snare that he used on the Ed Sullivan show, because that's from the first kit. Let's see if there's another Ed Sullivan photo in here. I thought there was somewhere. This picture. Get this picture here. Yeah, there's drop T logo head number two. Talked about Ludwig drum sales went up the day after the performance. Because everybody wanted a Ludwig Black Oyster Pearl kit, which I have myself. Sort of. I had half the kit. I got the floor tom here, and I got my snare over there. The snare is more, which I showed in other videos, more of the Ringo Black Oyster Pearl wrap. This is more of like a modern day wrap. Don't like this one as much as the Ringo one. The Ringo one's a classic one over there. But real quick here. I Want to Hold Your Hand. Featured on here, Meet the Beatles, released in January 1964, Capitol Records release. It's actually the opening track. And again, check out the description for more information, guys. There's a lot of information that I cover in these videos. And just going to keep it moving along here, but if I miss something or forget something or say something incorrectly, please read the description, because I always try to correct myself in the description. There's some cool photos during their U.S. tour, arriving in America, Meet the Beatles. I think there's actually footage of them during this in the hotel room, wherever this was. And they were literally hanging out, listening to themselves on the radio. Here you go, fact of the day, the Beatles bit. In September 1964, the Beatles made history big time. Their take for a concert in Kansas was $150,000, a record for that time. Okay, so... wow, they made it over $150,000, which, again, I mean, it's 1964. That's a lot of money back then. Today, maybe not as much. But, you guys going to get haircuts while you're here? I had one yesterday in the press conference. I think that's enough, guys. I'll keep the videos going. Please check the channel out. Check out the other videos I did for the show, and I'm just going to keep rolling them out. And thanks again. Please subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video. And on the Beatles show. Thanks, guys.